The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 51. When he had prayed to the Lord, his disciples came to him and said, "Oh, Master, two things we would know. One is how thou talkest with Satan, who nevertheless thou sayest is impenitent. The other is how God shall come to judge in the day of judgment." Jesus replied, "Verily, I say unto you, I had compassion on Satan, knowing his fall, and I had compassion on mankind, whom he tempteth to sin. Therefore I prayed and fasted to our God, who spake to me by his angel Gabriel. What seekest thou, O Jesus, and what is thy request?" I answered, "Lord, thou knowest of what evil Satan is the cause, and that through his temptations many perish. He is thy creature, Lord, whom thou didst create. Therefore, Lord, have mercy upon him." God answered, "Jesus, behold, I will pardon him, only cause him to say, 'Lord, my God, I have sinned, have mercy upon me.' And I will pardon him and restore him to his first state." I rejoiced greatly, said Jesus, when I heard this, believing that I had made this peace. Therefore I called Satan, who came, saying, "What must I do for thee, O Jesus?" I answered, "Thou shalt do it for thyself, O Satan, for I love not thy services, but for thy good have I called thee." Satan replied, "If thou desirest not my services, neither desire I thine, for I am nobler than thou. Therefore thou art not worthy to serve me, thou who art clay, while I am spirit." "Leave us this," I said, "and tell me if it were not well thou shouldst return to thy first beauty and thy first state. Thou must know that the angel Michael must needs on the day of judgment strike thee with the sword of God 100,000 times, and each blow will give thee the pain often hells." Satan replied, "We shall see in that day who can do most. Certainly I shall have on my side many angels and most potent idolaters who will trouble God, and he shall know how great a mistake he made to banish me for the sake of a vile piece of clay." Then I said, "O Satan, thou art infirm in mind and knowest not what thou sayest." Then Satan, in a derisive manner, wagged his head, saying, "Come now, let us make up this peace between me and God. And what must be done, say thou, O Jesus, since thou art sound in mind?" I answered, "Two words only need be spoken." Satan replied, "What words?" I answered, "These: I have sinned, have mercy on me." Said Satan then, "Now willingly will I make this peace if God will say these words to me. Now depart from me," I said, "O accursed one, for thou art the wicked author of all injustice and sin, but God is just and without any sin." Satan departed, shrieking, and said, "It is not so, O Jesus, but thou tellest a lie to please God." "Now consider," said Jesus to his disciples, "how he will find mercy." They answered, "Never, Lord, because he is impenitent. Speak to us now of the judgment of God." The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 52. The judgment day of God will be so dreadful that, verily, I say unto you, the reprobates would sooner choose 10 hells than go to hear God speak in wrath against them, against whom all things created will witness. Verily I say unto you, that not alone shall the reprobates fear, but the saints and the elect of God, so that Abraham shall not trust in his righteousness, and Job shall have no confidence in his innocence. And what say I? Even the messenger of God shall fear it, for that God, to make known his majesty, shall deprive his messenger of memory, so that he shall have no remembrance how that God hath given him all things. Verily I say unto you, that speaking from the heart I tremble, because by the world I shall be called God, and for this I shall have to render an account. As God liveth, in whose presence my soul standeth, I am a mortal man, as other men are. For although God has placed me as prophet over the house of Israel for the health of the feeble and the correction of sinners, I am the servant of God. And of this ye are witness, how I speak against those wicked men who after my departure from the world shall annul the truth of my gospel by the operation of Satan. But I shall return towards the end, and with me shall come Enoch and Elijah, and we will testify against the wicked, whose end shall be accursed. And having thus spoken, Jesus shed tears, whereat his disciples wept aloud, and lifted their voices, saying, Pardon, O Lord God, and have mercy on thy innocent servant. Jesus answered, Amen, Amen. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 53. Before that day shall come, said Jesus, great destruction shall come upon the world, for there shall be war so cruel and pitiless that the Father shall slay the Son, and the Son shall slay the Father by reason of the factions of peoples. Wherefore the city shall be annihilated, and the country shall become desert. Such pestilences shall come that none shall be found to bear the dead to burial, so that they shall be left as food for beasts. To those who remain upon the earth, God shall send such scarcity that bread shall be valued above gold, and they shall eat all manner of unclean things. Oh, miserable age, in which scarce anyone shall be heard to say, I have sinned, have mercy on me, O God. But with horrible voices they shall blaspheme him who is glorious and blessed for ever. After this, as that day draweth nigh, for 15 days shall come every day a horrible sign over the inhabitants of the earth. The first day the sun shall run its course in heaven without light, but black as the dye of cloth. And it shall give groans as a father who groaneth for a son nearing to death. The second day the moon shall be turned into blood, and blood shall come upon the earth like dew. The third day the stars shall be seen to fight among themselves like an army of enemies. The fourth day the stones and rocks shall dash against each other as cruel enemies. The fifth day every plant and herb shall weep blood. The sixth day the sea shall rise without leaving its place to the height of 150 cubits, and shall stand all day like a wall. The seventh day it shall, on the contrary, sink so low as scarcely to be seen. The eighth day the birds and the animals of the earth and of the water shall gather themselves close together and shall give forth roars and cries. The ninth day there shall be hailstorms so horrible that it shall kill in such wise that scarcely the tenth part of the living shall escape. The tenth day shall come such horrible lightning and thunder that the third part of the mountain shall be split and scorched. The 11th day Every river shall run backwards, and shall run blood and not water. The 12th day every created thing shall groan and cry. The 13th day the heaven shall be rolled up like a book, and it shall rain fire, so that every living thing shall die. The 14th day there shall be an earthquake so horrible that the tops of the mountain shall fly through the air like birds, and all the earth shall become a plain. The 15th day the holy angels shall die, and God alone shall remain alive, to whom be honour and glory. And having said this, Jesus smote his face with both his hands, and then smote the ground with his head. And having raised his head, he said, Cursed be everyone who shall insert into my sayings that I am the Son of God. At these words, the disciples fell down as dead. Whereupon Jesus lifted them up, saying, Let us fear God now, if we would not be affrighted in that day. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 54. When these signs be passed, there shall be darkness over the world for 40 years, God alone being alive, to whom be honour and glory forever. When the 40 years be passed, God shall give life to his messenger, who shall rise again like the sun, but resplendent as a thousand suns. He shall sit and shall not speak, for he shall be, as it were, beside himself. God shall raise again the four angels favoured of God, who shall seek the messenger of God, and, having found him, shall station themselves on the four sides of the place to keep watch upon him. Next shall God give life to all the angels, who shall come like bees, circling round the messenger of God. Next shall God give life to all his prophets, who, following Adam, shall go everyone to kiss the hand of the messenger of God, committing themselves to his protection. Next shall God give life to all the elect who shall cry out, O Muhammad, be mindful of us, at whose cries pity shall awake in the messenger of God, and he shall consider what he ought to do, fearing for their salvation. Next shall God give life to every created thing, and they shall return to their former existence, but everyone shall besides possess the power of speech. Next shall God give life to all the reprobates, at whose resurrection, by reason of their hideousness, all the creatures of God shall be afraid and shall cry, Let not thy mercy forsake us, O Lord our God. After this shall God cause Satan to be raised up, at whose aspect every creature shall be as dead, for fear of the horrid form of his appearance. May it please God, said Jesus, that I behold not that monster on that day. The messenger of God alone shall not be affrighted by such shapes, because he shall fear God only. Then the angel, at the sound of whose trumpet all shall be raised, shall sound his trumpet again, saying, Come to the judgment, O creatures, for your Creator willeth to judge you. Then shall appear in the midst of heaven over the valley of Jehoshaphat a glittering throne, over which shall come a white cloud, whereupon the angels shall cry out, Blessed be thou, our God, who has created us and saved us from the fall of Satan. Then the messenger of God shall fear, for that he shall perceive that none hath loved God as he should. For he who would get in change a piece of gold must have 60 mites. Wherefore, if he have but one mite, he cannot change it. But if the messenger of God shall fear, what shall the ungodly do who are full of wickedness? The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 55. The messenger of God shall go to collect all the prophets, to whom he shall speak, praying them to go with him to pray God for the faithful. And every one shall excuse himself for fear. Nor, as God liveth, would I go there, knowing what I know. Then God, seeing this, shall remind his messenger how he created all things for love of him. And so his fear shall leave him, and he shall go nigh unto the throne with love and reverence, while the angels sing, Blessed be thy holy name, O God, our God. And when he hath drawn nigh unto the throne, God shall open his mind unto his messenger, even as a friend unto a friend, when for a long while they have not met. The first to speak shall be the messenger of God, who shall say, I adore and love thee, O my God, and with all my heart and soul I give thee thanks, for that thou didst vouchsafe to create me to be thy servant, and madest all for love of me, so that I might love thee for all things, and in all things, and above all things. Therefore let all thy creatures praise thee, O my God. Then all things created by God shall say, We give thanks, O Lord, and bless thy holy name. Verily I say unto you, the demons and reprobates with Satan shall then weep, so that more water shall flow from the eyes of one of them than is in the river Jordan. Yet shall they not see God. And God shall speak unto his messenger, saying, Thou art welcome, O my faithful servant. Therefore ask what thou wilt, for thou shalt obtain all. The messenger of God shall answer, O Lord, I remember that when thou didst create me, thou said that thou hadst willed to make for love of me the world and paradise and angels and men, that they might glorify thee by me, thy servant. Therefore, Lord God, merciful and just, I pray thee that thou recollect thy promise made unto thy servant. And God shall make an answer, even as a friend who jesteth with a friend, and shall say, Hast thou witnesses of this, my friend Mohammed? And with reverence he shall say, Yes, Lord. Then God shall answer, Go, call them. O Gabriel, the angel Gabriel shall come to the messenger of God and shall say, Lord, who are thy witnesses? The messenger of God shall answer, They are Adam, Abraham, Ishmael, Moses, David, and Jesus, son of Mary. Then shall the angel depart, and he shall call the aforesaid witnesses, who with fear shall go thither. And when they are present, God shall say unto them, Remember ye that which my messenger affirmeth? They shall reply, What thing, O Lord? God shall say, That I have made all things for love of him, so that all things might praise me by him. Then every one of them shall answer, There are with us three witnesses better than we are, O Lord. And God shall reply, Who are these witnesses? Then Moses shall say, The book that thou gavest to me is the first. And David shall say, The book that thou gavest to me is the second. And he who speaketh to you shall say, Lord, the whole world, deceived by Satan, said that I was thy son and thy fellow. But the book that thou gavest me said, truly that I am thy servant. And that book confesseth that which thy messenger affirmeth. Then shall the messenger of God speak, and shall say, Thus saith the book that thou gavest me, O Lord. And when the messenger of God hath said this, God shall speak, saying, All that I have now done, I have done in order that everyone should know how much I love thee. And when he hath thus spoken, God shall give unto his messenger a book in which are written all the names of the elect of God. Wherefore every creature shall do reverence to God, saying, To thee alone, O God, be glory and honour, because thou hast given us to thy messenger. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, Chapter 56. God shall open the book in the hand of his messenger, and his messenger reading therein shall call all the angels and prophets and all the elect, and on the forehead of each one shall be written the mark of the messenger of God, and in the book shall be written the glory of paradise. Then shall each pass to the right hand of God, next to whom shall sit the messenger of God, and the prophet shall sit near him, and the saints, and the angel shall then sound the trumpet, and shall call Satan to judgment. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, Chapter 57. Then that miserable one shall come, and with greatest contumely shall be accused of every creature. Wherefore God shall call the angel Michael, who shall strike him 100,000 times with the sword of God. He shall strike Satan, and every stroke is heavy as 10 hells, and he shall be the first to be cast into the abyss. The angel shall call his followers, and they shall in like manner be abused and accused. Wherefore the angel Michael, by commission from God, shall strike some 100 times, some 50, some 20, some 10, some 5. And then shall they descend into the abyss, because God shall say to them, Hell is your dwelling place, O cursed ones. After that shall be called to judgment all the unbelievers and reprobates, against whom shall first arise all creatures inferior to man, testifying before God how they have served these men, and how the same have outraged God and his creatures. And the prophets, every one, shall arise, testifying against them. Wherefore they shall be condemned by God to infernal flames. Verily I say unto you, that no idle word or thought shall pass unpunished in that tremendous day. Verily I say unto you, that the hair shirt shall shine like the sun, and every louse a man shall have borne for love of God shall be turned into pearl. O thrice and four times blessed are the poor, who in true poverty shall have served God from the heart. For in this world are they destitute of worldly cares, and shall therefore be freed from many sins. And in that day they shall not have to render an account of how they have spent the riches of the world. But they shall be rewarded for their patience and their poverty. Verily I say unto you, that if the world knew this, it would choose the hair shirt sooner than purple, lie sooner than gold, fasts sooner than feasts. When all have been examined, God shall say unto his messenger, Behold, O my friend, their wickedness, how great it has been. For I, their creator, did employ all created things in their service, and in all things they have dishonored me. It is most just, therefore, that I have no mercy on them. The messenger of God shall answer, It is true, Lord, our glorious God, not one of thy friends and servants could ask thee to have mercy on them. Nay, I thy servant before all ask justice against them. And he having said these words, all the angels and prophets with all the elect of God, nay, why say I the elect? Verily I say unto you, that spiders and flies, stones and sand shall cry out against the impious and shall demand justice. Then shall God cause to return to earth every living soul inferior to man, and he shall send the impious to hell, who, in going, shall see again that earth to which dogs and horses and other vile animals shall be reduced. Wherefore shall they say, O Lord God, cause us also to return to that earth, but that which they ask shall not be granted to them. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 58. While Jesus was speaking, the disciples wept bitterly, and Jesus wept many tears. Then after he had wept, John spake, O Master, two things we desire to know. The one is, how it is possible that the messenger of God, who is full of mercy and pity, should have no pity on reprobates that day, seeing that they are of the same clay as himself. The other is, how is it to be understood that the sword of Michael is heavy as 10 hells? Then there is more than one hell? Jesus replied, Have ye not heard what David the prophet saith, how that the just shall laugh at the destruction of sinners, and shall deride him with these words, saying, I saw the man who put his hope in his strength and his riches, and forgot God. Verily, therefore, I say unto you, that Abraham shall deride his father, and Adam all reprobate men. And this shall be because the elect shall rise again so perfect and united to God, that they shall not conceive in their minds the smallest thought against his justice. Therefore shall each of them demand justice, and above all the messenger of God. As God liveth, in whose presence I stand, though now I weep for pity of mankind, on that day I shall demand justice without mercy against those who despise my words, and most of all, against those who defile my gospel. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 59. Hell is one, O my disciples, and in it the damned shall suffer punishment eternally. Yet hath it 7 rooms or regions, one deeper than the other. And he who goeth to the deepest shall suffer greater punishment. Yet are my words true concerning the sword of the angel Michael. For he that committeth but one sin meriteth hell, and he that committeth 2 sins meriteth 2 hells. Therefore in one hell shall the reprobates feel punishment as though they were in 10, or in 100, or in 1,000. And the omnipotent God, through his power and by reason of his justice, shall cause Satan to suffer as though he were in 10,000 hells, and the rest each one according to his wickedness. Then answered Peter, O Master, truly the justice of God is great, and today this discourse hath made me sad. Therefore we pray thee, rest, and tomorrow tell us what hell is like. Jesus answered, O Peter, thou tellest me to rest. O Peter, thou knowest not what thou sayest, else thou hadst not spoken thus. Verily I say unto you, that rest in this present life is the poison of piety and the fire which consumeth every good work. Have ye then forgotten how Solomon, God's prophet, with all the prophets, hath reproved sloth? True it is that he saith, the idle will not work the soil for fear of the cold, therefore in summer shall he beg. Wherefore he said, all that thy hand can do, do it without rest. And what saith Job, the most innocent friend of God? As the bird is born to fly, man is born to work. Verily I say unto you, I hate rest above all things. The New Testament Gospel of Joseph, chapter 60. Hell is one and is contrary to paradise, as winter is contrary to summer, and cold to heat. He therefore who would describe the misery of hell must needs have seen the paradise of God's delights. O place accursed by God's justice for the malediction of the faithless and reprobates, of which said Job, the friend of God, there is no order there but everlasting fear. And Isaiah the prophet against the reprobate saith, their flame shall not be quenched, nor their worm die. And David our father, weeping, said, then shall rain upon them lightning and bolts and brimstone and great tempest. O miserable sinners, how loathsome then shall seem to them delicate meats, costly raiment, soft couches, and concord of sweet song. How sick shall make them raging hunger, burning flames, scorching cinders, and cruel torments with bitter weeping. And then Jesus uttered a lamentable groan, saying, truly it were better never to have been formed than to suffer such cruel torments. For imagine a man suffering torments in every part of his body, who hath no one to show him compassion, but is mocked of all. Tell me, would not this be great pain? The disciples answered, the greatest. Then said Jesus, now this is a delight in comparison of hell. For I tell you in truth, that if God should place in one balance all the pain which all men have suffered in this world, and shall suffer till the day of judgment, and in the other one single hour of the pain of hell, the reprobates would without doubt choose the worldly tribulations, for the worldly come from the hand of man, but the others from the hand of devils, who are utterly without compassion. Oh, what cruel fire they shall give to miserable sinners! Oh, what bitter cold, which yet shall not temper the flames! What gnashing of teeth and sobbing and weeping! For the Jordan has less water than the tears which every moment shall flow from their eyes, and here their tongues shall curse all things created with their father and mother and their creator, who is blessed forever.